Very good morning, students. So in the previous class, we finished about a critical angle and the relation between the critical angle and as well as the refractive index, and also about a total internal reflection and mirage also finished. Actually, the two questions are very, very important: mirage and total internal reflection and critical angle. So you read the two questions and let us will move to the next topic, that is refraction at a spherical surfaces or and lenses also. This is the third topic, we can say lenses, because we are discussing about a, in this chapter we finished about a mirrors, that is a plane mirrors as well as the spherical mirrors also finished, and reflection is finished. In that second topic is refraction. In that refraction we discussed the different cases. Now let us, we are discussing about a refraction at a spherical surfaces. See, actually for the spherical surfaces are nothing but you take any spherical surface. Like you take a one spherical surface, that is a part of a sphere, refracting material is called a spherical refracting surface. A part of refracting surface. A part of refracting surface. So the light is refracted from the part. So we can call the spherical surface. Part of light is refracted from the spherical surface, which we can call as the refraction at a spherical surfaces. Usually here also we have some sign conventions, refraction for a spherical surfaces and lenses. We'll see the lenses in the next topic, but before that, refraction at a spherical surfaces, I'll tell you. See, some important terms related to the spherical refracting surfaces are there. Suppose you take a one spherical surface, it is a one spherical, so that here there is a line. The line indicates a principal axis. This is the principal axis, which is joining the center of the spherical surface, that we can call pole or vertex. It is a straight line which joining the center of the spherical surface or of the pole or vertex, we can also call vertex, which is joining the center, the line which we can call as the principal axis. Again, in this also we have center of curvature as well as the radius of curvature, because it is taking from the one spherical surface, one sphere. From that sphere, one part I taken, right? This is the one part. It is a one part, you say. Suppose from that part we are discussing, so that it is a, we can say it is a pole or a vertex, and it is a center of curvature as well as we can say radius of curvature also. This part we can also call radius of curvature. So the sign conventions are there. You say it is a spherical surface, we can take like this. It is a A and B is the spherical surface. The ray were going like this. Same thing, very same. The cases are like this. Your sign conventions are, if all distances are measured from the center, optic center only, all distances are measured from the optic center. So that all distances are measured from the optic center, if it is, if opposite to the light ray, ray of light, which we can take in as the negative, all distances. And second, if in the same direction, say in the same direction, in the same direction if I take, then we can say positive, same. The previous also, in the case of a spherical mirrors also, I told you very same this thing. And you take a height of the object is measured upwards, you take as the positive, and it is downward it is taken, then we can take it as the negative, which are the sign conventions. So it is very, very important. See, all are measured from the optic center only. All distances are measured from the pole of a spherical refracting surface. The distances measured in the direction of incident light are taken as positive, and opposite it is taken as the negative. These are the sign conventions are very, very important. Let us actually, by using this spherical surface, now we have to get one relation, that is a refraction at a spherical surfaces. Now we have to derive one expression to be like this. I'll give you one expression related to spherical surfaces, not lenses. We'll see the next lenses, right? There is a one refracting surface is given. See, one relation we want to derive. Suppose there is any one object is there, O, on the principal axis. Therefore, the ray which is propagating like this, when it is incident, clear? There must be, we can take like this, there is a light is incident at a particular angle of incident. You take a one normal here, because we should draw a one normal at this point. Yes, you take like this, which is making an angle incident, and it is an alpha, the ray which is making with the principal axis. Therefore, what happens? then the rays propagating and the image will form. Image due to the point object, there will be a image is forms at a one position, you say I. This is the image you take as the image is making an angle beta. Actually, refracting surfaces will be like this. See, there is a, you draw a one line, actually otherwise I'll give you, there is a one clear diagram, because you'll not get any confusion. You take spherical surface, right? There is a light ray which is incident, it is a O, and there is a normal you take which is making an angle I, and it is alpha. Therefore, the ray which is to be reflected, it forms an image, it is making an angle beta. Actually, refracting surfaces are nothing but here also one surface will be there, and here due to this object, this refracting surface image is formed at a distance. This you say object distance, and here this is the object O, and therefore this is formed a image at a I. But here another also spherical surface will be there, because in lenses we have two surfaces. So due to that, this image is propagating through the next surface. This image is propagating through the next surface, next refracting surface, so that is again forms a another image. It is a final image which may forms. This you say I dash is the final image. This is will form, the image will be at a center of curvature, or you say it is a point is you say C. This is the image will be I dash. Clear? Now you take a sum O, it is I, and you say N, which you draw a one line which is almost parallel to this one, right? Which one? For this lens or this for spherical surface. So that here O, N, M, oh, I mean to say it is M you take. And here there is a refraction angle you take a R, and it is you taken as a delta it is. Very clear it is. Is it okay now? Therefore, the light is propagating from one medium to another medium. This is will be the image distance. And here you say it is a mu 1 is the refractive index, it is you say mu 2 is the refraction. Light is propagating from one medium to another medium. Therefore, there is a final image will be formed at a C. That is you say at a refractive index is R. Like this is given. Now we should derive an expression by using this all given rays. So you take a from triangle. Now I am giving one triangle ONM. ONM. You take like this ONM. See, from this you tell me tan alpha. It is opposite, you say NM by, it is OM. This is the equation 1. It is for tan alpha. In the same way, you tell me another triangle also is there, that you say NMI. NMI. From the triangle NMI, again you take a tan beta, because we are taking tan beta. Beta opposite is, you say MN by, it is MI. Right? And you go for the next triangle, it is MNC. You tell me tan delta is equal to opposite is MN by MC. So this is equation 2, this is equation 3. Look at, actually there are some angles are given, incident angle as well as the refraction angle is given. According to the incident angle, you take a here the angle of incident I, which may be NOC. You look at here NOC from triangle NOC, right? This is the one triangle is there, no? Angle of incident is I is equal to, we can write like this, angle of incident is equal to alpha plus delta, because the angle is like this. It is one angle, right? Here actually we know I and alpha and delta we know. What is alpha here? It is given as MN by OM, and here delta is given as MNC. You write here angles are very small. Therefore, we can take like this, NM by OM is 1. Here also delta is equal to MN by MC, right? These two expressions here you write. Therefore, I is equal to alpha will be NM by OM plus MN by, you say, MC. This is you give as fourth expression. And from again, look at here. From triangle, another triangle also is there. You take your again. I want to get a R value. So that for that R value, you take as the next one is, it is we can take as the delta minus beta, that is NMI. You take from triangle MNI. So that here R will be delta minus beta we can. because it is nothing but a what we are taking, what we are taking only this refraction angle. So we know again delta, and from here also you write here beta is equal to mn by mi. So here you write refraction angle is equal to delta will be mn by mc minus beta will be mn by mi. This is equation 5. Here we know I is equal to, we know, and as well as r is equal to, we know, but according to the we can say, I mean to say, the ray of light is propagating from 1 to 2, no? You write here 1 with respect to 2 is equal to sin I by sin r, right? Here mu, that is mu 2 by, we can say mu 1 is equal to sin I by sin r. Very simple, you cross multiply, therefore sin I mu 1 is equal to mu 2 into sin r. Of course angles are very small, therefore sin I which almost equal to I, and sin r which almost equal to r, we can say, so that mu 1 I is equal to mu 2 r. Here we know I and r values. This is you take as the equation 6. Now substitute this 4 and 5 in 6, right? Mu 1 I will be, it is nm by om plus mn by mc is equal to mu 2 into r will be mn by mc minus mn by mi. Clear? So in this you take a mn, mn, mn is common and cancel it, therefore mu 1 of 1 by om plus 1 by mc is equal to mu 2 of, I mean to say, 1 by mc minus 1 by mi. Actually this relation is related to the next coming classes, which is important for the next classes. So that here we know you multiply this m1 by om plus m1 by mc, m2 by mc minus this one is there m2 by mi. Now I am writing here, you remove this, look at now, from there I am continue. Now I am continue from there, you multiply mu 1 by om minus, I mean to say, plus mu 1 by, it is mc is equal to mu 2 by mc minus mu 2 by mi. So you do one thing, your mc is there, you take this side and this you take this side, almost we are in ending, plus mu 2 by mi which is equal to mu 2 by mc minus mu 1 by mc. So here look at here, mu 1 om is represented, you are here right u, and this is a mu I, right? So I mean to say mi will be equal to v, and here mc is equal to r. These values substitute here, then almost we'll finish it. Mu 1 by u plus mu 2 by v is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. This is the expression related to spherical surfaces. So the expression related to spherical surfaces, which will be like this. Here it is, the given is like it is, we can write, right? And coming to the point is, here we should apply a sign convention also, because the object distance is measured opposite, no? So that you take u is equal to minus u, and image distance is measured along the same direction, you say v plus, and r also measured in the same direction, so that the equation will be mu 1 minus u plus mu 2 by v is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. Therefore the final will be mu 2 v minus mu 1 u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by, so this is an expression. This is an expression related to refracting at a spherical surfaces. Refracting at a spherical surfaces. Therefore, this equation is very, very important in the next lenses. That's what, if we know this derivation, and it is very easy in the next classes. Clear? You go through this derivation and you remember, when the light is propagating from one medium to another medium at a refracting surfaces of a given spherical surfaces, the relation will be mu 2 by v, that is the refractive index of a second medium by image distance minus refractive index of a first medium and by object distance, and mu 2 minus mu 1 by refractive radius of curvature. Like this it is related to refracting at a spherical surfaces. Clear? And coming to the magnification also, we have to find in case of a spherical refracting surfaces. We'll see that that is also right. Let us now you take another diagram for the magnifications. Same in case of a spherical refracting surface only. You remember this formula is very important. Not required to read, but you should remember the expression. Which one? This expression. Mu 2 by V minus mu 1 by B, right? Now let us write a magnification. Magnification. In this lateral magnification, lateral magnification. So we know lateral magnification in the sense is there is it is in a spherical surfaces. If the object is you take a extended object, like you take when there is an object is placed, it is object height is you say h naught. Therefore the ray were goes and which may forms a real image, real and inverted image will form, which may be like this. It is a image I. So the refracting surface ray will goes and there may be a image is forms like this. It is propagating through the center of curvature like C, and it is we can also take R, therefore which making like this. Clear? There is an A. We know magnification is nothing but a, it is the height of the image by height of the object that we know, right? Magnification in the sense is height of image by height of object. Of course it is measured in downward hi by h naught. This is the magnification. It is in terms of object and image, right? But from the Snell's law we can also take like this. There is an refraction angles are there, it is an incident angle and it is we can say refraction angle. By using this you take as a optic center P and it is an image. No, from this we can write like this from Snell's law, that is about a same mu is equal to sin I by sin R, which propagating from 1 to 2. So you write here mu 2 by mu 1 again, then sin I by sin R. You cross multiply mu sin I, that is mu 1 sin I, mu 2 sin R. So mu 1 I is equal to mu 2 R. Of course I is nothing but it's opposite by this, here also this by this. Shall I take like this? Therefore which may get like this. Here it is I will be, it is h naught by object distance, R will be, it is the image. No, so that it is opposite h I by V. Here mu 1 h naught by u is equal to mu 2 h I by V. Very simple. You take a magnification according to this magnification, you say here cross multiplication mu 1 V by u is equal to mu 2 h I by h naught. Clear? And therefore the final expression will be, it is h I by h naught is equal to cross multiplication mu 1 by mu 2 half v by u. So this is will be the magnification, that is m is equal to mu 1 by mu 2 half v by u in case of a spherical refracting surfaces. This is in case of a lateral magnification. Lateral magnification, like we have longitudinal also. I'll give you directly formula because it is not required. Once you go through this lateral magnification, because it is a derivation related to lateral magnification. Lateral magnification, right? Now I'll tell you longitudinal magnification at a refracting curved surfaces. This is lateral. No, you take as a longitudinal. That is about a longitudinal magnification. So it is, I'll give you directly expression. Longitudinal will be, you take as like ml it is. So here the expression which represented like this directly, actually ml is nothing but a longitudinal. No, we can say change in image distance by change in object distance. When there is a small object of a length is du is placed on the axis, producing the image is dv, or it is along the axis of refracting surface, that you say object height difference in the object image in the difference, so that it is dv by du we can, ml is equal to dv by du we can. So that the from this, if you take a derivation, because already we know mu 2 by v minus mu 1 by u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. If you take a here it is the differentiation with respect to that object and the image, therefore then the final will be represented like this. Final will be represented for the longitudinal magnification directly we can take. So taking the differentiation on both side, we'll get like this. ML is equal to, it is will be mu 1 by mu 2 into v by u whole square, right? In this we'll get the simplification. If you take a simplification here, you multiply mu 1 by mu 2 into mu 2 by mu 1. If you take like this, therefore of course it is will be cancelled. Therefore what we'll get after that, ML is equal to longitudinal will be m square into mu 2 by mu 1, because you multiply this mu 1 square and mu 2 square, so that it is whole square v by u whole square. That v by u whole square is nothing but just now lateral magnification, no? That lateral magnification will be, it is mu 1 by mu 2 into v by u, but it in terms of square is there, no? Because if you multiply this, we'll get like this, that is mu 1 square by mu 2 square into v by u whole square into mu 2 by mu 1. So here instead of this mu 1 by mu 2, v by u you take as a m, then we'll get the lateral magnification will be like this. Longitudinal magnification will be like this. Clear? This is related to magnifications, two magnification. One is a lateral magnification, one more is a longitudinal magnification. Clear? And here I'll tell you one other one also related to this. See, we should remember some focus points, principal focus according to the expressions only. Here you write, there is a one more issue which is important for the lenses, because in the next topics we have only lenses. So that you say principal focus or focus or foci, right? Suppose we know the equation, that is about a very simple expression we know. Just now we derived mu 2 by v minus mu 1 by u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. This is the simple expression related to this. Now based on this, if the object is at an infinite, sir, what will happen the image? So for the refracting surface you take, when the object is at infinite, no? So that it is light ray will coming from the, it is a principal focus, therefore the image will form at any focus point. Like this will get image. This is, we can say the image will be formed at a like this. So that here you say it is a mu 1 is the refractive index, it is a mu 2 is the refractive index. So suppose the image or distance is you take as a v, here you write mu 2 by v minus mu 1 by 0 or infinite you say, therefore mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. So mu 1 by infinite is nothing but it is becomes a 0, then mu 2 minus mu 1 by r for this. Therefore the light ray work conserves at a focus point. This is the focus point f2. We can take both focus points, no? F1 and f2, right? So it is a for one, so that here f2 is nothing but a, we can say from this if you calculate, we'll get the mu 2 minus mu 1. That is the v is equal to f2, no? V is equal to f2, no? Here the image will be formed at this, no? So cross multiply, 1 by v is equal to, it is a mu 2 r by mu 2 minus mu 1. Here v is equal to f, no? Then f2 is equal to mu 2 r by mu 2 minus mu 1. So that here f2 is equal to cross multiply mu 2 minus mu 1 by mu 2 into r, when the object is at a distance is infinite. Suppose if the object is at a distance of focus point, you say when the object is at a distance of focus point, let us you take another one. If the object is at like this, therefore image will form at an infinite to be like this. See, image distance is infinite, you say mu 1, it is mu 2, therefore u is equal to, you say it is at a focus point f1, because this is the focus point F1. Therefore, the ray work goes like this. Then it forms at an infinite, image will be infinite. Mu 2 by V minus mu 1 by U is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by R again. So, this will be gone 0 minus mu 1 by, of course, it is also measured enough. Therefore, mu 2 minus mu 1 by R. This minus, because it is measured in opposite direction, no? That what you say U is equal to negative it is. So, F1 will be cross multiply, it is directly will get mu 1 R by mu 2 minus mu 1. This is will be like this. See, these are the focus points related. So, F1 is equal to, it is will be mu 1 R by mu 2 minus mu 1. Of course, it is, we can also take as F1 is equal to F2. In this case, we can also take as the F1 is equal to F2. Clear? F1 is equal to also we can take F2. Therefore, you take this divide. If you take this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Therefore, you divide like 2 by 1 or 1 by 2. Then all will cancel. So, that will get F1 by F2 is equal to, or you want to say F2 by F1 also no problem. Then you divide this F2 by F1. What will happen? Mu2 minus mu2 is cancel. Mu2, mu2, mu1, mu1 is cancel. Therefore, we will get only, otherwise you write mu2 minus mu1 by, it is mu2 by R by mu2 minus mu1 by mu1 by R. So, R cancel, mu2 cancel. F2 by F1 is equal to mu1 by mu2. Very simple. So, F inversely proportional to mu. This is the relation, right? Okay. So, this is through the spherical surfaces. Again, we have the power also we have to find through the spherical surfaces. So that here we'll see in the next class whatever the spherical surfaces are related power, and after that we'll have lenses. In that lenses we'll see more derivations are there. So thank you very much. We'll see in the next class.